morning and welcome to Peace. We're glad you're here on this beautiful morning. Let's begin by singing praises to the Lord.
Amen.
To see Jesus.
Open our eyes, Lord, as we gather today in your name. Open our ears to listen. We pray that our hearts be open too, God, so that we might see, hear you, and then respond out of love. This week, in Jesus' name, amen. Welcome to Worship at Peace, everybody. You may be seated. It is good to be together. We are hearing from Luke's gospel, and today we have Jesus teaching his disciples, and we who seek to be his disciples today, the Lord's Prayer. How do we pray? And Jesus responds with what we now know as the Lord's Prayer. This is about what Jesus is most passionate about. And today, in the message that's going to be brought to us from Brendan Nelson, we'll hear some particular reflections about the youth love to the local serving mission week that happened a couple weeks ago right here in the Hilltop. Please see the picture slideshow that we sent out in the All Church email. It's a YouTube video to check out to see pictures of our young people serving in the neighborhood. I'm excited because we're coming off of the special congregational meeting. It just happened here in the multipurpose room and on Zoom, in which we have now given a green light, approved the building of a DADU, a detached accessible dwelling unit, a two-bedroom house, so that we can expand the housing ministry of the church from three families in affordable housing to four families, of course, upon completion of that DADU, which will take time and money and energy. But thanks be to God that God's leading us in this expansion of this very important ministry of this church in this Hilltop neighborhood. It is a blessing to worship together in person. It is a blessing that technology connects us with all, wherever you are, for worship today. So welcome if you are worshiping online today. We, as we are in person, gather with masks. We wear masks, concerned with the safety and the health of all. And we blow air in here to keep the airflow, to create this atmosphere. And I encourage you to be sensitive to the social distance, what people think of in terms of what they're comfortable with social distance these days. So we share communion today, a couple options. You can do it in person in the traditional manner, coming forward to receive bread, wine, or grape juice, and then back to your seats. We also have the prepackaged communion, if that's better for you, located at the welcome table or up front. Let me know if you would like that. And then if you are online today, please prepare bread, wine, or grape juice to receive communion wherever you are at that appropriate time. For children, we have a cry room in the back. It's useful maybe for some families. We also have pew pals, which are children's coloring sheets that connect with the scripture readings for the day. Miss Rebecca is here, ready to provide childcare in the basement nursery area, and there will be children's worship time today. That'll come right after the scripture readings. So God's blessings to all the children in our midst. As we begin worship today, we acknowledge that Peace Lutheran Church is located on the traditional homelands of the Puyallup people of the Coast Salish Nation. We lift up the vision God's given us to be a diverse community of faith right here in the Hilltop where all are welcome. A community that is spirit-filled, compassionate, healthy, reconciled, and just. It is a blessing today to know that we will be able to hear from our new interim executive director of Peace Community Center, Arthur Padilla. That's later in the worship service. Arthur in the back, welcome to you and blessings to you. Thank you for serving in this way. So we'll be able to hear from him later in the worship service. Right now, it is good to acknowledge that our God is a God of peace. Amen? And we need peace in our lives, in our families, in our neighborhood, in our nation, and our world. We are called to be peacemakers and peace sharers. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Thank you. Please take time right now, wherever you are, to share peace with the folks around you. God's peace.
Please join me in prayer. Gracious God, thank you for this morning, for the good news about the DADU, for your presence with us and your love. Open our eyes and ears to hear how we can learn from you, from how to pray best with you and to serve you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
It's now time for the readings.
I come to you with Psalms 138. I give you thanks, O Lord, with my whole heart. Before the gods, I sing your praise. I bow down toward your holy temple and give thanks to your name for your steadfast love and your faithfulness, for you have exalted your name and your word above everything. On the day I called you, you answered me. You increased my strength of soul. All the kings of the earth shall praise you, O Lord, for they have heard the words of your mouth. They shall sing of the ways of the Lord, for great is the glory of the Lord. For though the Lord is high, he regards the lowly, but the haughty he perceives from far away. Though I walk in the midst of trouble, you preserve me against the wrath of my enemies. You stretched out your hand, and your right hand delivers me. The Lord will fulfill his purpose for me. Your steadfast love, O Lord, endures forever. Do not forsake the work of your hands, the word of the Lord. Coming to you with Luke 11, 1 through 13. Jesus was praying in a certain place, and after he had finished, one of his disciples said to him, Lord, teach us to pray as John taught his disciples. He said to them, when you pray, say, Father, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Give us each day our daily bread and forgive us our sins. For we ourselves forgive everyone indebted to us. And do not bring us to the time of trial. And he said to them, suppose one of you have a friend And you go to him at midnight and say to him, friend, lend me 3 loaves of bread, for a friend of mine has arrived, and I have nothing to set before him. And he answered from within, do not bother me. The door has already been locked, and my children are with me in bed. I cannot get up and give you anything. I tell you, even though he will not get up and give him anything, because he is his friend, at least because of his persistence, he will get up and give him whatever he needs. So I say to you, ask, and it will be given to you. Search, and you will find. Knock, and the door will open for you. For everyone who asks receives, and anyone who searches finds. And for anyone who knocks, the door will be open. Is there anyone among you, if your child asks for a fish, will you give a snake instead of a fish? Or if the child asks for an egg, will give a scorpion? If you then, who are evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will the Heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask him? Word of the Lord.
Be seated, everybody. It is time for children's worship time. Children, I hope you are looking around when you walk through this building and see the amazing decorations. We're getting ready for Compassion Camp this week. It's Summer Bible Adventure. It's Tuesday through Thursday evenings from 5:30 to 8, and it is going to be amazing. So anybody who's listening online, too, come by. It starts with a meal and have fun, skits, Bible stories, crafts, activities for kids. So kids, now you can go with Miss Jaina and Mr. Nick, right? And you'll be back a little bit later in the worship service. And now, before I invite Arthur up for Peace Community Center mission moment, I'm going to invite Antonio Yun forward for a council report. All right, one thing at a time here. Thank you, Antonio.
All right, good morning. So as Pastor stated earlier, we did have a meeting a little bit about a half hour ago regarding the detached accessible dwelling unit to be built on 21st and Cushman. We met and motion was made and approved to go forward with the design of the DADU by DADU Homes. And also motion was made and passed and approved to seek funding for about $525,000, which includes a little bit of the cushion to be able to build that home. And then, as Pastor also mentioned, Tuesday through Thursday, July 26th to the 28th, 5:30 to 8 p.m., is a Summer Bible Adventure for our children here and families. August 7th, a Ugandan musician is going to be leading our worship service. Group Igena by Lasana Sana will be here, so please come for that. On August 14th, we will only have the 11 o'clock service, and it's an outdoor worship service followed by a cookout fellowship, so come hungry. And and on September 11th will be our Rally Sunday, which school starts again, and it'll be a time for celebration on that regard. Also, Brendan, who leads our stewardship team, with faith and land stewardship cohort, is now going to be pursuing other avenues, additional avenues for our housing ministry. So also as part of the church council, I also want to thank the many of you who continue to give generously through your offerings, and ask you to continue to do so to benefit the ministry of our church. So thank you so much.
Thanks, Antonio. And now Arthur Padilla, please come forward, Interim Executive Director of Peace Community Center. Welcome, Arthur. Let's give thanks to God for Arthur being present today.
Wow, that's the least work I had to do for an applause. Thank you very much. Two thumbs up. Good morning, everybody. My name is Arthur Padilla, and I am the interim executive director at Peace Community Center. I started 2 weeks ago, and I found out about the community center about 3 weeks ago. So I'm moving a little bit quickly. I won't be here very long. I'm going to be here a very short period of time. I'm here for just as an interim period as we find new leaders. But I am jumping in feet first, so if you have anything you want to do with the community center and I can be of any assistance, please let me know. As you know, the community center has had some transition with the ED leaving and the development director leaving. They both left on the same day. It was a very strange first day, and we've had fun ever since. We're going to continue moving forward. The community center is in excellent shape. I just want you to know. I've been able to talk to everybody and see things, and what a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful place, and what a beautiful legacy you all have created here. So I'm incredibly humbled to even be in the space. And I thank you all for the work that you do to save children's lives. When I was young and in this experience, I did not have anybody to help save my life, so I am seriously grateful that you all are here. I think it's really important to remember that we are moving forward, and one of the most important things we do is raise money for all of these young people, and we'll be doing our Learners to Leader program in the spring, which is our annual fundraiser, and I am asked to ask you to put that on your radar, that we will be coming back to you looking for table captains and continued support of the center. I really appreciate the time that you've given me today. And again, if you need anything from me, please reach out to the center and to our staff. I'm so grateful for everything you do. What a beautiful, beautiful experience this has been so far. Thank you.
I did not get a round of applause, so I'm just kidding. Thanks for indulging that. That's good. You know, so interesting, the last time I gave a sermon, I had a sweater on. I was like, I can't believe this is summertime and I have a sweater on. And now it just feels like summer, and we're going to feel it this week. So stay hydrated and stay healthy, please, this week. So I have to admit, as we think about our scripture for today, just the Lord's Prayer had me thinking about how I failed back in the day in my youth group, thinking I knew it, but I was adding my own kind of words in there and adding different things, and I failed. But since coming to Peace and reciting it every single Sunday definitely did something to me. So I had to sharpen myself with it. But just thinking about how it's not just a prayer, but it's a tool. This is how you do it. It's a learning piece for us. And it's been so great just to even dissect a little bit more into the scripture. And there's so many ways we can go with this, and I was thinking about all these different pieces, but as Pastor John said, I really wanted to connect this to the Love to the Local Mission Week, so if you would indulge me a little bit, we're going to make that connection. But we're really going to focus on one particular portion of that scripture today. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven is where we will go today. So I have a question for you. You know, I like to get you all's feedback. And right now at 11:27, what do you think is going on in heaven right now? What do you think people are doing in heaven at this time?
Singing,
all right? Praising God, right? They're shaking their head about us. Ooh, That's an interesting twist there, all right. This morning I heard they're probably having Sunday brunch in heaven right now. Loving one another, right? Ooh, karaoke, all right. It's perfect. I can see that going down right now, some karaoke in heaven. So we hear these things that we can imagine going on in heaven, the excitement, being together. Let's think about here. What's going on here? What's going on in our community? What's going on in our city? What's going on in this world? You said not karaoke. Yeah, that is very true. Good. Lots of hard things, but we're trying to embrace the beauty that is around us. Yeah. What else?
In the category of hard things, war and violence, yep, in our streets, and racism.
Yep. War, violence, racism. All these things we can see and we have experience happening in our world. Now, would you agree with me that God has no problem having his complete will done in heaven, right? Based on the things we said that might be going on right now, sounds like people are pretty much going with the flow and doing what they need to do. I have no doubt that what God says is heavenly is being done. Those folks are listening to him and engaging with him and enjoying his presence. So then how come things are so difficult for us here? What's the problem here? Why do we have such a hard time carrying out God's will? If you think about it, the Bible gives us really great instructions, right? Somebody used to call it the basic instructions before leaving Earth, right? The Bible gives us exactly what we need if we took the time to really dive into it, to really understand it, and spend time with it. It would open our eyes to so many things. The problem is sometimes we don't want to do the work that it takes to understand what is being asked of us. The problem for me is it's not the understanding of God's will, but it's when it collides with our will. Think about the things that we lifted up that are happening in our world right now. Right? We're living in our own spaces and places. You might agree, and I've been here myself, that sometimes we have considered ourselves to be a little bit more important than what we are. We've all been there at some point in our lives. We've considered what we said to be the final thing. Parents, probably been there, right? My word is final. That is it. And we've probably found ourselves being consumed with ourselves sometimes, whether it's through grief. We can't find the joy in certain things, but finding ourselves to be consumed. And some of those things at times have exceeded God's will. And that's just been proof in a lot of things that we see in the world. I was with a group of young people a couple weeks ago, and the question came up of, why do you think it's our community is struggling? And why is our nation struggling? One person said, she said, because people are self-centered. It's all about ego. And that was very true. If we think about this, our culture today is as divided as it's ever been. Think about it. Our relationships are as strained as they have been in recent times. People are treating each other with more disrespect and disrespect over masks and physical distancing regulations and how you feel about COVID and how you don't feel about it. And we are battling in our communities with whose lives matter. And we are hearing that some lives don't matter. And we are seeing that played out right in front of us. But I think Jesus was right on when he challenged his followers to pray a mighty prayer of perspective. Invite the kingdom of God to come. Emphasize God's will on earth. And put our differences aside by forgiving others as we have been forgiven. And asking us to trust God to supply our daily needs. And recognize that the real enemy is not within us. There's something much deeper that is going on. I'll tell you, our nation needs to heal. Our communities need to heal. But despite all that we have lost, we are still in this together. We need to be in this together. And if we are, God will continue to bless us as we seek the welfare of this whole community and really embrace his plan. As I was reflecting on kind of this particular passage of the scripture, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven, maybe it's really start to think about community and how we are together. And that's really what God has called us to do, is be in community together. So, as Pastor John shared, we've had the Love to the Local Mission Week just a few weeks back. And it was a great week. Things happened where we had to make some adjustments, and we'll share more about that. But I want to give you a little bit of background around it. I'm now in my 7th year here at Peace, and every year we've gone on a mission trip, with the exception of these last 3 years. And so when COVID hit, and I was like, I don't know what we're going to do about a mission week this year. This was 2020. And so Pastor John and I met, and I was like, I don't know. I don't think we should do anything. Things are just uncertain. But then it was like, we have to do something. So my mind went back to a few years prior when we had gone to Portland. And we spent a week there, and it was amazing. It was a smaller group than we have had in the years prior, and it was actually turned out to be perfect because we got a chance to have some more intimate conversations and learn a little bit more about each other. And in that, we've had our conversations, and as we were engaged in service, we had some really heavy lifts that week. One, we served at the Union Gospel Mission, where people were transitioning from drugs and homelessness and really tough life situations. We served at a shelter for women and their children who are trying to be reunited. We were educating them and playing games with them, but seeing the turmoil that was going on in families and within the community weighed heavy on us. And as we reflected in the van, kind of heading back to our site where we're going to be staying, a question came up from one of our youth. And she said, Mr. Brennan, can we do this at home? Can we serve at home? She said, there are things that are happening in Tacoma just like are happening here. And then we thought about it and pondered and said, yeah, well, what are some of your ideas? And we started throwing things around and what we can do. And then the next day we get on into our next service day, and we're going through a tiny home neighborhood. And we all said together, man, this looks like the Hilltop. And we thought, what can we do back home? And that's kind of where the Love to the Local started to go. Karina Gillis was the youth that asked that question and got us going. So here we are now in our third year of the Love to the Local Mission Week. Wasn't our intention. We thought by now we would be in the van heading to another location to serve. But God has called us here for another year. So when we came into this week, that service week, Elise McWilson, who has a deep heart for service, said, I want to help lead and plan the week. She was getting a gold star or a gold ribbon, a gold award for her Girl Scouts. And a part of that was to lead an activity, and this is what she took on. Amazing. God's will being done here. I want to share a few highlights with you about that week. We started off this year, it wasn't as hot as last year. Y'all remember last year, it was 93 degrees on our first day, and actually one day we had to cancel because it was way too hot. So we started a day later. But this week we started out recognizing the need for support of one of our neighbors. Ron Barnes, who passed away about 6 months ago. And if you had looked at that house and his yard 3 or 4 weeks ago, you wouldn't be able to tell what was going on there, and it looks totally different today. I said to the youth, hey, this is the work we're going to be doing. Here's what we're going to do. There were no complaints. Everybody was like, I'll take a tool. I'll do this. I'll do that. Some of which they've never touched a hedge trimmer or a weed either. And honestly, I was a little bit concerned about the lawnmower that would take you so far. I was hoping for no injuries. But the youth loved it, and they engaged. We didn't anticipate our allergies flaring up the way they did. I think we were all sneezing for the next 3 days after that. But there was care and concern for Ron, and they haven't even met Ron. But knowing something needed to be done. That job took pretty much all day, and we didn't get finished with it. We were going to tackle it again. So the next day, what we had planned was to work in the garden here with Mr. Craig, and then we were going to go over and work on the MLK corridor. And if you've seen in the MLK corridor, there are these big planters, and we were going to clear those out, put some new soil in there. And kind of at the last minute, I switched our schedule around and said, let's go do the planters first. The weather wasn't cooperating with us. So we did the planters first. And as we got back towards this way, we hit 19th and MLK. And all I hear is, Mr. Burton, what's going on? And look around, and there's cop cars everywhere. And I said, I'm not sure what's going on. And we look, and there's a canine unit. And I was like, okay, this is not good. So we get back to peace. And as we hit this street, there's a dead body laying in the grass just across the street from us. Just steps away from the garden where we were going to be working that morning. Had our schedule not changed, that's where we would have been. So we went into this mode of like safety, security. Jane and I were like, hey, let's get the youth to safety. Got in there, probably not sure what was going on. And we had 20 young people in our building as well. But for us to pull up on the scene with young people and they see caution tape everywhere and things are roped off, it was concern. And so as we got kids to safety and secured the building, I made phone calls to folks. And I struggled with calling Pastor John because I was like, he's on vacation. But I think this is something he would want to know. And as we talked, I struggled with, like, do we continue with this service week? It's a hard thing to process. And so we made the decision to take the next day off. And making phone calls was a little bit difficult, talking to parents, hearing their concerns. But having young people say, I still want to come, I still want to work, was powerful. Wanting to be in community together was something I heard. That Friday, there was a peace walk in memory of Ayanna. And I look around, and there were so many people from Peace. People that didn't even know Ayanna, but heard the news or got the phone call and activated and showed up. For me, this is what this is about. Being in community, God's will being done here. The truth is all over Scripture. God has intended for us to be in connection and community with each other. Right from the start of Genesis, when he says, it's not good for man to be alone. From when he was sending his disciples in twos. And then through the incredible model of community we see in Acts. People of Peace, we were meant to do this life together. To draw from one another and to support each other through the good and the bad. And together we find out how we fit in this world and we find God's hope for our future. To me, that's what it is to see thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. The things you mentioned about what's probably going on, people singing together, people working together, people loving one another. That's God's will for us. Serving your neighbors who you've never met, but helping to accomplish a need. Walking with your brothers and sisters in community against gun violence and the hate that we are experiencing. That's God's will being done. I pray that we continue to seek biblical solutions, but also we activate ourselves to go a little bit further and get involved to take steps to face the things that are plaguing our neighborhoods and communities. I pray that we can reconcile, and I pray that we ask God to have his will done here in the Hilltop, in Tacoma, on the east side. Have his will be done here as it is in heaven. Amen.
So we now come to the time of the service where we share about life and ministry of the church. I have a couple of announcements to share. Brendan mentioned the garden across the street. You're invited to come and help work in the garden 10 a.m. on July 28th, August 11th, and 25th. And Summer Bible Adventure is this week, which Antonio mentioned. That's Tuesday through Thursday from 5:30 to 8. Compassion Camp is the theme, where the kids will come together and have a great time and learn about love and compassion. So there's a sign-up link in the church email and also on the registration table at the welcome table. And Pastor John has some announcements.
Inviting Mr. Brendan back up for a word. Oh, when he gets there, here he comes. Important for our community engagement and community outreach.
Had to run and get the flyer really quickly. So there's a lot that's going on in the Hilltop this coming week. We are fresh off the heels of voting here at Peace to build a DADU on our property. So one of the things that's part of my role is really engaging in other elements of work that are happening in the Hilltop, in particularly around development. And one thing I wanted to share with you is there will be a tour. It's called the Modular Prototype Tour. I'll tell you a little bit about this. It's a group called Forterra who purchased the old Rite Aid facility off 11th and MLK. You've probably seen it now. It's really bright and beautifully colored. Kids are dancing there all day throughout the summer. But that's going to be a site for a housing development that will break ground in 2024. First of its kind here in the United States. Pretty much a short story about it. It is built in a factory at 98% completion and then brought to site to be put in, for lack of better terms. And so this is huge. There are kind of recycled materials that will be used. It's called kind of some green construction and some mass timber that will be used for this. So it's one of three sites that will be underway here soon. So Saturday, well, actually right now it's here, but Saturday there'll be an opportunity for people from the community to come and tour this development. You'll actually get to see what it will look like in real life when it's all complete and finished. A lot of the work that will be in this development has been done by local black artists from the Hilltop Tacoma area. So that's amazing to see. But this is a way that Forterra has addressed affordable housing. And it's an innovative way of being able to do that. I thought it'd be important to share that with you all at Peace, because we continue to journey together and discern how God is calling us to do more work around our housing ministry. There will be some music, food. Miss Berta, if you know Miss Berta, she used to be our cook for the community center. She's going to come out, pull her truck out, and do some cooking for us. And it'll just be a good time to be in community with one another. I have the flyer here. It's Saturday from 10 to 2. If you have any other questions, please let me know. But again, this is a great way for us to show up for the Hilltop neighborhood. And I'm excited that this is coming to Hilltop. If you haven't been on that corridor, go check it out. The Housing Authority is building their development that will open in October. And that will house folks transitioning out of homelessness. And it's been designed by Tiffany Hammonds, a local artist. She has a beautiful mural up right now. It's amazing, y'all. So there's great things happening in the Hilltop. It's not perfect, but we are growing, and the more we can lean in with one another, the stronger our community will be. So thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Brendan. And Berta's food, that's some good stuff. Something else is happening on Saturday, this coming Saturday, July 30th, from 10 to 2, and that is a rally on the Capitol steps in Olympia, a Love Thy Neighbor rally. So Lee and I and our kids are going to be going, a few other folks from Peace. So you got two really important things happening at the exact same time, one in the Hilltop, one down in Olympia. You'll have to choose. This is concluding a month that has been proclaimed by our governor as Love Thy Neighbor Month. The Tacoma Ministerial Alliance, of which I'm a part, is behind this. And the idea with this rally is we are rallying for love and respect. It's a positive rally. It's about connecting across differences. It's about lifting one another up. And so if you would like to go, there are some buses that are going, leaving at 8:30, and that's coming from a Greater Christ Temple. I can give you all the information about that. Just let me know. We could do some carpooling as a church. So that's happening also on Saturday. And then a word, Brendan and I, as the two full-time church staff folks, take Mondays off. So just wanting to let people know that. Probably not everybody knows that about our schedules. It is really good for us to have those Mondays. Now, if an emergency comes up and you got to break through to us, please do that, especially to me, because I'm available for emergencies. But please, we're asking not for folks for not to text or call us about church-related things if it can wait until Tuesday or after in the week, so that we can have our renewal time in the week and our family time, and that's a really helpful time. Wanting to let you also know we'll just say a word right here of thanks. Thanks to Brendan, thanks to Jaina, thank you to Craig Cogger, thank you to all those other folks who helped contribute to the Love to the Local Week. Special thanks to Elise McWilson, who Brendan mentioned, our youth, who helped co-lead this entire week. What an amazing blessing she is. She's on the church council as the youth representative and provided such incredible leadership for that. So thanks be to God for the way our whole church has leaned into the Love to Local, and also how you all are leaning into this coming week of Summer Bible Adventure. Really looking forward to it. Special thanks in advance of the actual week to Jaina, who is our coordinator of children, youth, and intergenerational ministry, to Jeannie Correa, to Carmen Lampman, and to so many others for making this all happen. Let's give God a round of applause for these amazing summer experiences. Thanks be to God. Thank you for your ongoing sharing of the gifts and talents that God has given to you, the way you're doing that, sharing your time, talent, treasure in all aspects of your life, and a special thanksgiving to the way that you are financially giving to support the ministries of Peace. We don't pass around an offering basket, but please, there's the offering box at the table, there's going online to the giving link or setting up electronic giving. Thanks be to God for the generosity of this faith community. And I wanted to invite everybody right after worship. We've got some goodies. You can grab some refreshments, go through the multipurpose room at the kitchen counter, and we can hang out outside and just share fellowship together. That'll be a blessing. I'm going to invite Kit back up here to collect thanksgivings and concerns. Actually, I will run around and collect them, and then Kit will lift them up to God in prayer. And it's a good time for you online if you have any of those. And I don't know if, are you able to capture those if they're online? Or
yes.
Should Brendan's got those.
Oh, Brendan has them. Good.
Okay. So if you're online and you want to lift up your thanksgivings and concerns in the comments, please do.
So let's start with sharing with thanksgivings and praises for things that are happening.
Any thanksgivings?
Mr. Ben.
Ben's raising his hand right in front of me. Okay.
Because it's the longest way to go. Just really thankful for what we heard this morning from future directions on our affordable housing program. I'm just thankful that we're in a community that where we have these wonderful people working for us and creating homes.
Yes, and I'll just say one of my thoughts of gratitude is no single person can do this kind of work. We need to do it together, as Brendan said in his sermon today, and to be part of a community where my individual presence joins others and we can really be making a difference. Now it will be four families with some housing that can be a little more affordable. What a blessing. Brendan?
I just want to just give a thanks to Jaina. I came by yesterday to see the setup and try to help with anything, and I came in and it was just like so amazing. So thank you for your leadership and how you're leaning in to this work. I was just really excited to see that, and having done it for so many years, I was like, I know what it takes. So you handled everything really well, and I'm excited for our children and families to experience Compassion Camp this week.
Yes.
I just want to give thanks for Arthur's presence with us in the interim role. We have a chance to go for a walk, and just his energy and positivity. He didn't tell you about his resume, but the experience and wisdom he brings, I just think it's a huge blessing to our community.
Thanks be to God for you, Arthur. Thank you.
All right, how about, oh.
Let me come to you so you can use the mic.
Thank God that I'm here today. I haven't been there well. But I'm my family, so I'm here today.
Thanks be to God. Yes.
I just want to thank God for all the support that you guys give for my family and the prayers. So that's so important when you're having trials.
Great time at Wright Park last Wednesday, and we had a great group of kids playing, so Peace at the Park was really fun, and was able to talk one-on-one with people that I haven't been able to, so it was a great day.
Thanks be to God.
All right, how about prayer concerns and requests?
Pray for my brother in Idaho. He tried to commit suicide. Aww. Pray for the Clay family.
Yes.
Our daughter has a swollen arm, and it's typical of her. Once a year, she gets cellulitis. So we're in urgent care, and I think we'll go again today. So pray for her.
Mm-hmm. Prayers for joy.
My friend Consuelo, who's worshipped with us here, died this week after a lot of trouble. So prayers for her mom, Lynette, and her dad, Miguel, and her family.
Yes. I'm going to add a few more prayer concerns. So lifting up Kelsey, who's the mom of Ayana, who died, 14-year-old girl, in the Hilltop a couple weeks ago. Prayers also for Brendan's dad at the death of his sister, grieving. Prayers for healing for Joe Blake and Katrina Sorter, hospitalized at St. Joseph Hospital right now. For Rob Preston, for healing and for health and strength. For Pastor Plain and Carol Plain. Pastor Plain was hospitalized this past week, is home now, continues both of them to have physical struggles. Kisela McDaniel, Emma's daughter, is starting cancer treatment. We pray for her. And I pray for the future directions of Peace Lutheran Church as we're living into our foundational commitment to anti-racism, our ministry of place, especially through the housing ministry that we are continuing to expand, especially with the meeting today, And we pray for peace, peace in our neighborhood, peace in our nation and our world.
Thank you. Brendan, I'm not seeing any prayer requests. You didn't see any either. Okay, thank you. Please join me in prayer. Gracious God, we thank you for your loving presence with us today and always. You hear our concerns, our grieving, our worry about loved ones, the need for healing. We know that you are the great physician and will heal hearts and minds and souls. We ask for that both in our community and in our nation and our world, that with all the struggles going on. We ask that you help us to be a part of the solution of all these ills, that we will continue to come together in community to serve and love one another so that we can see your kingdom on earth as it is in heaven. Yeah. In Jesus' name, amen.
Listen to your children pray. Lord, send your spirit in this place. Lord, listen to your children pray.
Time now for a foretaste of the heavenly feast to come. This is our meal of Holy Communion that we share together in God's presence. For in the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat, this is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Now let's pray in those words that Jesus taught us that we call the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. This is our Lord's meal, and all are welcome to share in this meal in the presence of Jesus, receiving the gifts of God, of life and love and forgiveness. Please know, if you're worshiping here in person, that the dark cup is the wine, the light cup is the grape juice. We do have a gluten-free option for the bread today, and I'll encourage you to follow the instruction of our usher today, Ben, who will help you forward at the right time. If you'd like to use the prepackaged version of communion, maybe you picked it up at the welcome table, or I have some here if you would like that. If you are worshiping online today, it's time to find the bread, the wine, or grape juice and receive them with the words, "The body of Christ given for you, the blood of Christ shed for you." These are the gifts of God for the people of God. Amen.
Let us break bread. together on our knees. Let us break bread together on our knees. When I fall on my knees with my face to the rising sun, O Lord, have mercy on me. Let us drink wine together on our knees. Let us drink wine together on our knees. When I fall on my knees with my face to the rising sun, O Lord, have mercy on me. Let us praise God together on our knees. Let us praise God together on our knees. When I fall on my knees with my face to the rising sun, let us break bread together on our knees. Let us break bread together on our knees. When I fall on my knees with my face to the rising sun,
as you're able to receive blessing before we leave today.
The body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. May God bless you to be a blessing this week. In Jesus' name, amen. In peace and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.